is. It's time to do art with Miss Orr. Yay!
Good morning, amazing Stage 1 team. I'm so excited for you to be here to create another amazing artwork. Today we're going to be creating an artwork that has some native flowers and plants that can be found here in Australia. Did you know there are over 24,000 species of native Australian plants and flowers here in Australia? And they only can be found here. How special is that? Do you know any native flowers or plants? Let me tell you some of the most popular plants. The Banksia tree, the gum tree, the bottle brush, the wattle. Wattle is one of the most famous plants that we have here because it represents our Australian colours, green and gold. The waratah, a grevillea, kangaroo paw. And no, that doesn't mean an actual kangaroo's paw. The flower actually just looks like a kangaroo's paw. The native bluebell. And the last one I'm going to say is the everlasting daisy. Do you know any of those plants? I've added some photos for you to see. But do you think we should get started on our artwork? I agree. Let's go. Okay, so I've got my A4 piece of paper. I've got it landscape. I will be using my fine art line pencil today. And remember, that means you will need a lead pencil. I've got my trusty Sharpie pen as well with me to do some outlining. I'll be using some paint. Remember, if you don't have any of these materials at home, it's okay. Use what you have. I've got oil pastels as well. Some leaves. You might have some leaves at home you want to add to this artwork, and that's totally fine. You might want to use some pencils. I also have some textures handy in case I decide to use them. I've got these little sticks that I'm going to be using to create our first flower. Oops. And you could use anything similar, or you don't need to have them. It's just an idea. And some earbuds as well, some cotton tips. Okay, let's get started. So I'm going to start drawing the stems to my flowers and plants. Okay, so I'm going to start my stem in the bottom corner. Now I'm going to be using my fine art line pen, and remember, that means you guys need to use your lead pencils to do this first step. So I'm going to do a curved line to create my first stem. There we go. And I'm going to do another one. I'm going to make these two overlap. Yours doesn't have to look exactly like mine. Be creative. How do you imagine the native flowers all growing together and overlapping? I might add some extras as I go along as well, but I'm probably going to start off with around 5 maybe, and then I will see how I go. So as you can see, I've got some going over the top of each other and some going underneath each other. Okay, so the first flower we're going to start is going to be the bottle brush. So I've got my red paint here, and I'm going to grab one of my little sticks, and this is going to help me create that really straight lined look that the plant has. So I'm going to add this paint onto the edge of my stick. There we go. Remember, you don't want too much, but you also don't want too little, because otherwise it won't print. So we're going to flip this stick around very carefully. Make sure you ask permission before doing this if you would like to use step paint at home. So I'm going to turn that around and press down just like that. There we go. And I'm going to create my own lines to resemble the flowers that the bottle brush plant has. So as you can see, some of the paint is now starting to become thin, so I'm going to add a new layer of paint just so I can continue to keep adding and adding as many as I would like. There we go. Press, press, press. Perfect. I'm going to now start going around, curve it around at the top. Beautiful. And I'm going to add a little bit more paint. And then I'm going to finish the other side. I paint the ghostly gums. I am Clancy on his horse. I made Kelly on the run. Yay! My bottle brush is now finished, so it's time to move to our next flower. And we're going to be doing the native wattle plant. So this is one of the famous plants in Australia that I mentioned before. So how I'm going to create the wattle, I'm going to use some vibrant yellow paint and use our cotton tips. And I'm going to just put a bit of paint on the edge. I'm twirling it around to make sure it's got an even amount of paint on the end. once I'm happy with the amount of paint, I'm going to dab our cotton tip to create circle shapes resembling the beautiful flower that the wattle plant creates. And we're just going to keep dabbing that around until we're happy with the amount of dots we've got. Now remember, if you've got a little bit of gaps in between your dots, that's fine. But if you want to fill those gaps with more circles, that also would look awesome. Okay, so now I'm going to show you how I'm going to add some gum nuts just to fill in the little gaps that I've got here on my piece of paper before I keep going. So I'm going to do a curved line just like this, and I'm going to now put a little gum nut. So I'm going to do an upside down U. I'm going to connect those edges with a curved line going upwards, and then I'm going to create like a circle on the bottom, just like that. I'm going to add some more. So again, an upside down U. Connect each side with a curved line, making a half moon. And then we're going to do a curved line on the bottom. There we go. And it gives our gum nuts a 3D effect. So I'm going to add some branches, and I'm going to keep adding some gum nuts onto the edges of these. So again, upside down U, curved line, circle bottom. Upside down U, curved line, circle bottom. They look so cute. I love gum nuts. So to quickly tell you what gum nuts are actually the non-edible fruit that the eucalyptus tree creates. So it's like a little fruit, but you can't eat it. I know a lot of birds like to have a little try of it, but they are very hard. I'm going to continue to add some leaves now for my gum nuts. So just like the eucalyptus tree, I'm going to do some skinny, downwards facing leaves. Before I continue, I'm actually going to add some more in the little gaps that I can see on my piece of paper. Okay, the next flower we're going to create is called the protea. Now, the protea actually originates from South Africa, but it was brought here to Australia, and it now grows here as one of our native plants. So we're going to do a U shape, and then on top of the U shape we're going to do some kind of, not exactly zigzag, but some swirly lines, so just some loose wave lines. Then we're going to curve that in to kind of make it look 3D. Now for the leaves and the patterns outside the flower, we're going to be doing some half circle shapes, and we're going to layer them on top of each other, kind of like what you imagine feathers to be like on a bird's body. Now, the further up the flower we get, we're going to kind of make our shapes go a little bit higher, a little bit more pointier, a little bit more narrow. There we go. And we're going to continue that all the way until we get to our squiggly line at the top that we created. And that's resembling all the beautiful petals on our flower that's on the outside of the protea. Now we need to do the leaves. So these leaves have an upwards formation, so they face upwards, they kind of surround the outside of the flower. So I'm just going to keep adding them around. There we go, and they've got a curved edge. Beautiful. Around again. Now when I get to the wattle, as you can see, I'm just going to pretend that it goes behind. So I want to make that layering look. So I'll make sure that I continue to do that as I keep going. Okay, I'm so excited. This is one of my favorite plants. So the Banksia, I'm going to quickly show you a photo of it. As you can see, the Banksia has like a rough looking texture, so it's got like a fluffy outside, but it also looks a little bit spiky to touch. So it's in a long oval shape. So I'm going to do three Banksia plants for mine. There we go. And they're going to go upwards. Now the Banksia you would have seen on the photo has little seed pods as well, so we're going to have to create that. So when it's ready, when it gets to its time, it ends up opening these seed pods, and all these little baby seeds come out and it plants a new tree. So as you can see, I'm going to do a seed pod. So I'm going to do a upside down U again, another line, a little middle line, and then at the bottom, I'm going to add another line. So the inside, as you can see, that's where the seeds come out. Curve, curve, around, around. Curve, curve, around, around. Curve, curve, around, around. Now yours don't have to look exactly like me. You could just do circles if that's easier. But maybe have a go, try your personal best. I'm sure it will look amazing. Okay, so I finished adding my little seed pods and my Banksia. I also decided to add a cheeky little other gum nut plant at the bottom. Now I'm going to keep adding the other leaves to the rest of my flowers. Okay, so now that I've finished doing my leaves, it's time to start colour. So on the wattle tree, I'm going to actually colour around my dots now that they've nearly dried. So I'm going to be adding some background colour, so some yellow, so it kind of makes our plant glow a little bit and stand out. We share a tree.
I'm the black soil of the plains. I'm the mountains and the valleys. I'm the dry.
All right, now onto our little gum nuts. I'm going to be using my brown and green pencil. So I'm just going to do a dark outline of brown on the top edge of my gum nut. There we go. And remember, you can color them however you'd like. This is just my idea on how I'd like to color them. So I'm going to be using then my green to add another layer of colour. So usually gum nuts can be between the colours green and brown. Some are more like an olive looking green and others are very dark brown if they've dried out. So I'm kind of going for that in between colour. Then I'm going to go back over the green with some brown to make sure it all blends together. There we go. Perfect. Now I'm going to move on to my other ones as well. Okay, so I'm now going to colour in the Banksia. So I'm going to grab my black and brown pencil and I'm going to make it very spiky and fluffy looking like the real one looks like. So I'm going to kind of go in with a scribble technique and I'm going to be kind of just filling in all the white gaps. I'm going to leave the seed pod. So I really want to make sure that I'm going around the seed pods. I don't want to get any color on them because I'll be doing them at the end. So I'm just going to be roughly colouring in, leaving those seed pods, trying to colour around them the best I can. And I'm just going to keep doing this crazy technique all the way until I've filled in all the white gaps. Now remember, you can go over the outside because they do have that hairy look on the outside of the plant. So I'm going to keep going and go up here and make sure that I change the direction of where my spikies are coming out of. There we go. Perfect, and then I'm going to grab my black pencil after I finish this and I'm going to do the exact same technique, filling in those white gaps that I haven't filled in yet and just going back over the patterns that I've created, because usually the Banksia can be seen as like a grey brown colour, a black brown colour, so I wanted to add both of the colours. If you have a lead pencil at home, you could also add a third colour on top, which would look really awesome. I don't have a lead pencil with me, otherwise I think I would also be doing that. Now we're going to colour in the seed pod. So in the middle part, I'm going to colour that just plain black. So I'm going to be pressing quite hard on my pencil to make sure that that entire area is black. There we go. The middle part. And that's where the seed would be kept. and then I have to color the other part of my seed pod. So I'm going to be taking my brown and I'm going to be pressing pretty hard for that as well, so they stand out compared to the background color we have used for this plant. There we go, and I'm going to keep doing that to all my other seed pods. Yay, it's looking so good. I'm so happy with how it's turning out. I can't wait to see yours.
I'm the hot wind from the desert. I'm the black soil of the plains.
I'm the mountains and the valleys. I'm the drought, the flooding rain. I am the rock, I am the sky.
All right, now it's time to move to the protea. So for the protea, I'm going to be using some oil pastels. I'll be using the colors red and pink. Remember, if you don't have this at home, you can use anything you want to color. You could use textures, crayons, anything you would like. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to start off with a little bit of brown, I've decided, just to make sure that it looks a little bit 3D. So I'm going to color the bottom base of the flower with a tiny bit of brown. You won't really be able to see this once we add color, but it just gives it a little bit more depth, which makes it look a little bit more 3D. So I'm going to just add a little bit of my pencil on top of that. There we go. Beautiful. Now I'm going to try blend the colors from red to pink. So I'm going to try my personal best. I'm going to take the red, and I'm just going to start layering these colors because I want it to look vibrant, but I also want it to blend beautifully. So very carefully, I don't want to press too hard and go over the beautiful patterns that we have made on the outside to resemble all the petals, but I'm going to have to keep adding and adding to make sure that my color is vibrant. So I'm going to blend that brown into the red, make it a little bit darker at the bottom. There we go. And then I'm going to start adding a little bit of pink above this red, just so we can blend it into the lighter color pink that will be at the top of this flower. So I'm going to start to blend, blend, blend.
And the mountains and the valleys, and the drought, the flooding rain. I am the rock, I am the sky, the rivers when they run.
The spirit of this great land, I am Australia. We are one, but we are many, and from all the lands on earth we come, we share our dreams and sing with one voice. I am
you. Now that that's colored, I'm just going to use my light pink pencil to shade in the top part, which would be the inside of the flower.
And from all the lands on earth we come, we share a dream.
Taking my green pencil and green texture, I'm going to start coloring in the leaves. So every leaf for each plant I'm going to do a little bit different. So I'm going to start off with my gum nut. So I'm going to do a thick outline. So on the, I'm going to outline the leaf and then underneath do a thicker line just as a shadow. So I'm going to then color it in with my green pencil, and I'm going to keep coloring all the way to the end of the leaf. And then once I've done that, I'm going to grab my texture and add a little bit of detail at the edge. There we go. And I'm going to do the same on all the other gum nut leaves. There we go. And grabbing that texture again, adding some detail. Perfect.
I came from the dream time, from the dusty red soil plains. I am the ancient heart.
Okay, now I'm going to do some more of my leaves. So for these leaves, I'm going to grab my green texture. I'm going to outline them just so I can do my best coloring and to make sure I've got a border of where I can color.
For 40,000 years I've been the first Australian.
I'm a teller of
Now I'm just going to grab my oil pastel and color in each of the leaves.
I am Clancy on his horse. I made Kelly on the run.
I'm the one who wants Matilda. I am Australia.
We are one, but we are many.
All right, so now I'm just going to color in the rest of my leaves. So these ones and the other ones at the top. And then I will be nearly finished. You might have seen as well, I've started to outline all of my flowers and plants in my black Sharpie as well, just to make sure that they pop. Alright, so now I am finished our native Australian plants and flower artwork. I hope you enjoyed it. I'm so excited to see yours because I know it will be unique and amazing in its own way. Make sure you upload a photo of your finished masterpiece, and I look forward to seeing you next week for our next artwork. Bye guys, keep smiling!